So when you first, when did you first hear about me?
I had just 2 days prior hopped off the plane from Lebanon, where I had left my dream job and my dream man all behind. And AJ was in my parents' laundry talking to people about his run trip. And I was very suspicious. Not about what he was saying, because I really liked what he was saying, but why on earth would you tell me he did? That's just stupid. Even if you are, just don't talk about it.
Which happens, by the way, to be my law of attraction last week as well. I've had lots and lots of people, quite a number of people, email me about why I'm so stupid as to say I'm doing this. So we met then at, it's about just before New Year's, a year and a half ago or so. And how was I with you?
You mean it seemed handsome?
Just go with it.
You didn't talk to me, and I wanted to talk to you about what you were saying. And I was very frustrated because I was asking you questions and you just didn't seem to answer.
I was very shy. You don't believe me. No, I was. I was very shy. I couldn't even put two words together properly. But go on.
Okay. And then I found out a few weeks later that AJ felt that he was my soulmate. And I thought that was very strange. On a number of levels. Firstly, because I didn't want to be any kind of biblical figure ever. And secondly, because he didn't talk to me. So I stewed on that for a few weeks. And then I thought, I'm not having this man going around the world thinking that he's my soulmate, talking to other people about it and not me. So I emailed him and I said, what are you doing? What's going on? Please tell me what you think. And then I thought that he would just email back and go, oh, it was just something I thought. It's not anything.
A big mistake.
Yeah. Which I continued to believe for about 6 months.
So I was overseas by this stage. So I was overseas, and I get this email. And by the way, the date that the email was dated was February the 14th. Unintentionally, but it was Valentine's Day. And anyway, I just saw this Mary Luck, and then this, I forget what the subheading was now, but I just saw Mary Luck, you know, on my inbox. And I was so afraid to actually open a message. Because what had happened a few weeks earlier before I left Australia was that Mary, I could feel some quite strong anger emotions from Mary, particularly about me saying that I was here. So that was the main issue. And then all of a sudden I get this email from Mary, who I felt at that time, and still feel, of course, was my soulmate, right? So all I could do is just sit there for a while in stunned silence, looking at my inbox. And eventually I opened it and there was this lovely message. Well, I thought it was lovely. We read it again the other day, just in the... It was a two-line message saying, what the hell are you doing? I'm talking about me.
And
was there. What did I miss?
You missed the yell that came from the room. Yes, it was!
Yeah, that's right, So we were in Dallas at the time. And on our travels overseas, and yeah, I was quite happy about the situation. Yeah, and then I wrote an email in reply. So what did you think about that email in reply? Yeah.
I guess I went through a lot of really strange emotions then, because AJ wrote back and said, yes, I think you're my soulmate, and lots of other lovely things about, I can't bring them to mind at the moment, but I felt very confused because this is a man that I had just met and really not really felt any connection to, but I felt very drawn into this interaction with him. So we corresponded for a little while, and I continued to be very distressed about the whole Jesus situation. And eventually I decided that I would join him on his travels in the UK by then.
She's brave, hey? She's brave.
Well, I have the kind of personality that I don't like to leave any stone unturned. And also, I have an internal nature, so I needed to sort it out for myself, what I thought about that. But I continued to feel that I would get there and he would spend 5 minutes with me. But, oh no, I was wrong, and it's definitely not the good one. We just continue on with our lives. I'd have a nice holiday. I didn't really think that. And then 4 days into spending time with AJ, I actually had a very large emotional experience that I couldn't explain. That seems to happen a lot. I don't know. I don't know what you want to know.
You want to know about the emotional experience?
I had a very strong feeling of grief and some rage at him that I couldn't understand, and had a lot of feelings about him leaving me and dying. And really scared me a lot. And it didn't happen in any kind of visible way or biblical way. It was just a very raw emotion that I felt concerned him specifically. So that lasted about half a day of me grieving and writing and having feelings about having been a mother as well. And then I really freaked out because I wasn't expecting that. And
because if you can just imagine for a moment that you've lived a life on earth where you're not conscious of any of these things, then you meet a person and all of a sudden you have this experience that you've had a previous life together, and that they died and left you with a child, and all of a sudden all of those things, so these are not pictures in your mind, but they're just feelings, emotions inside of you. If you can imagine that for a moment. And that's the beginning of Mary's, I suppose you could say, awakening as to what's really going on inside of yourself. That was the beginning of it. And since then, it's been a series of those kind of events. And
I'll just add that even when I was entertaining the idea that AJ was Jesus and that I was the soulmate, I at no time thought that I would have a memory like that. Like, I didn't even think about grief as a wife and mother. Because I went through a lot at that time about, am I inventing this? How can I? What is happening? I've never experienced anything like this. And I kept looking for rational explanations as to why this is why am I feeling this? And I couldn't find any. And part of the emotion I felt at that time was, you can't be with this person because it's emotionally dangerous. It's just going to, it can happen again. You'll lose him, or I'll lose him. Yeah. So that, because of that, we ended up spending, I just became more and more afraid about what was happening. But we ended up being apart because I couldn't reconcile this experience with my life as I wanted it to be. And I still have issues with that because it's not really where I saw my life going. And